Code Home Rule, Traditional Government for Modern Times. St. Mary's County is currently run by the commissioner form of government and has 5 elected commissioners. But the laws for St. Mary's County must be approved by 43 senators and 147 delegates in Annapolis. This process can take up to 21 months, and if you want to attend a public hearing on a law for St. Mary's County, you have to go to Annapolis in the winter. Under the form of government called Code Home Rule, St. Mary's County would still have 5 elected commissioners. However, those 5 commissioners would have the authority to approve laws for St. Mary's County in a process that would only take 2 months, and the public hearings would take place in Leonardtown. Since the inception of the Code Home Rule form of government in 1966, several other Maryland counties, including our neighbor Charles County, have adopted it for its greater efficiency and transparency. Other Maryland counties have adopted a different form of home rule called charter. St. Mary's is one of only 6 Maryland counties that does not have some form of home rule. Under Code Home Rule, the county commissioners would have authority to enact, amend, or repeal any public local law. In other words, any law that affects only St. Mary's County. The commissioners would not have authority over laws that affect more than one county or over statewide laws. The state legislature would retain that authority. And the state legislature would still retain authority over new taxes and fees. Code Home Rule would not mean more taxes. In addition to power gained by the county commissioners, the citizens of St. Mary's County would gain the power of referendum, a power that our current form of government does not provide. Under Code Home Rule, a referendum can be required with a petition signed by at least 10% of the county's registered voters, filed within 40 days after a local law is enacted, amended, or repealed. The new legislative process would also allow for more transparency in the formation of local laws. Under Code Home Rule, the commissioners would designate and publish a schedule of up to 45 days throughout each calendar year for conducting legislative business. This way, the public would know when laws are being considered. The name of the commissioner who sponsors a law would appear on the bill, so that the public will know who has proposed the law. A public hearing on a proposed law is immediately scheduled to take place at a time at least 7 days after the law is first introduced, in order to give the public an opportunity to comment on the proposed law. If a proposed law is amended, the entire proposal must be reprinted locally so that the public has an opportunity to see any changes. A local law can only be enacted on one of the designated legislative days so that the public can be in attendance. And the vote of each commissioner is recorded in a journal. Any new law must be published at least 3 times during the following 4 weeks and cannot become effective until at least 45 days have passed. This permits the public to exercise the right of referendum. Adoption of Code Home Rule begins with the proposal of a resolution by the county commissioners. But first, the public has a right to be heard at least 2 public hearings. Currently, there are 7 public hearings scheduled to take place at locations throughout the county. The commissioners will make a decision whether or not to proceed with a resolution within 60 days of the last hearing. The voters have the final say in a referendum. The resolution would appear on the ballot on November 8, 2016. If the voters approve, Code Home Rule would become effective on December 8, 2016. Adopting Code Home Rule would mean for St. Mary's County no new taxes, no county executive, no new departments, and no new costs of government. It would mean local legislative hearings, the right of referendum, efficient and transparent government, and accountability of the elected officials who enact local laws. It's up to you to decide.